Hey, I have this problem, okay? Okay, I have several problems, but my primary problem today is that I hate using cheat sheet. Not because cheat sheet's bad, but because I just have a sucky workflow. Like when I want to do it, you know what I do? I open up a new terminal, I go in here and I curl cheat sheet, and then I have to leave the terminal, then jump back, or I create a new tmux window and then I jump in here and then that's where I do my little curl and do that and then it shows up, okay? And then I have to jump back, I got to go back to one this time. And then I have this window that's just hanging out there. I don't want that window hanging out there. That sucks. No, I don't want that. So we're going to fix that, okay? Me and you together, let's fix it because you know what? I want the greatest developer workflow that has ever existed, okay? I want everything at the touch of these sweet little fingies. Why am I closing my eyes and doing spirit fingers? Well, guess what? You don't need to know the answer to that, but you will want to know the answer to this little cheat sheet gimmick. So let's do it. Let's jump in and let's make something way more incredible together. All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a little thing called cheat sheet. Oh, looks like I already have it. Well, maybe this isn't the first time I'm recording that. I ran out of air there. I actually ran out of air. All right, so what is cheat sheet? For those that don't know, you can simply go like this, cheat sheet, and then you can provide, say, a language, and then after that, you can provide some sort of query string with the plus instead of spaces, right? Or you can do the exact same thing, but instead of using a language, you can do a core util. Util, and then you can, people hate utils too, I love them. And then you can also do an operation if you really want, and then you can forget that part and do that, bam. So a good example of this thing would be, okay, let's just paste a couple extra of those, and let's go golang slice. All right, let's take this, let's just try it out. Oh, I don't even believe you could do that. Look at this, okay? Look at that. That's how you do them. Slices. Okay, it tells you all about slices. Then you can even do more than that. You can also do learn, which is, obviously that was a terrible thing I just did there. You know what I just discovered with doing this learn stuff? It turns out if you do learn slice versus learn slice, they give you two separate answers. I almost kind of like this one a little bit better. Huh. Kooky. Anyways, you can learn a lot with using cheat sheet, but like I said, I hate this part because now I gotta go in here and I gotta kill that previous window. Now that previous window is gone, I'm back to Vim. Awesome, I like this. I really don't want to open up a Vim terminal and do all the same stuff. That seems, okay, so we're gonna do this together. So the first thing I'm thinking is that you're gonna want a list of languages, right? Because we need to know what type of query we're gonna do. So let's go like this. Let's go a little tick and go echo, golang, lua, cppc, TypeScript. I think that's pretty much everything that I mostly use. All right, and we're gonna take that, we're gonna pipe it in to tr and replace those spaces with those sweet new lines. All right, awesome. Let's do the exact same thing, but let's go like this, core utils. Now, obviously I could do a little bit different here, but let's not go crazy, right? X args, find, move, sed, I don't know how I got zend in there, and awk. Do the exact same thing. Now, let's figure out what you want to search for. So let's go selected equals, and let's pipe these two to FCF. But you know what? I'm terrible at bash. So, okay. You know what we're going to do? We're going to do a little testy test. Okay. I'm going to take this echo and let's go like this. Languages, core utils. Okay. Let's see what happens here. My guess is it won't be quite correct, but you know what? I think it could be. Okay. So let's go. What did I call this? Just cheat. All right, so now that we've done that, let's just run to cheat sheet. Here we go, and as you'll see, everything is looking not good. That is terrible! All right, let's go back and let's fix this problem. So echo doesn't work. You gotta use printf, if I'm not mistaken. Printf, you know, you can put new lines in. Echo, you know, I mean, all right, so we put that in here. We rerun cheat sheet. Oh, that feels good. That feels good. All right, so I think we got everything we need. So let's go like this. Selected equals little tickies and then pipe that into FCF. You know why we're gonna do that? Because check this out. Let's go like this. Echo, selected. And then let's put selected again because I forgot to put the dollar sign first, but this makes more sense. It feels like we're selecting something. Let's hit golang. Look at that. Look at how good that is. Let's do it again and let's go with find. Oh, you gotta love it, okay? You gotta love it. You love it. I love it. You love it. Let's love it together. Let's make... You're right, Karen. I don't think I can't say that, can I? No. YouTube is family friendly, isn't it? Yeah, I know. All right, let's get back into this. Okay, so now we actually have the selected item. So now we need some input from the user. The classic read P, give them the prompt. Let's pass in a little query right here, and let's assign it to the variable query. Boom, now we're looking real good, except for one thing. We need to know, have we selected a language or a core util? Because they do operate a little bit different. So let's go like this. Printf, languages. Pipe that into grep qs, and then let's look for selected. Now, if we get this, then guess what? We got it. All right, wrong language again. Wrong language. All right, so let's go like this. Language, and then let's take this, paste it here, go in here, and let's go core util. Okay, this is looking good. Okay, if we've done this right. Yeah. All right, so now we're over here. Let's jump into here. Let's do Golang. Oh, query. I don't know why I have that in there. Language, beautiful. Actually, I remember why. Because we programmed it. All right, cheat sheet. Let's do this again, and let's do xargs, and that was a Q, and then query can be that core util. There we go. So we know when we're selecting a language versus a core util, this is looking real good. We pretty much have this, okay? We have it by the core utils. All right, so now we just need to contact cheat sheet. Let's go like this. Curl cheat sheet. Selected, and then now we need to go like this. Echo, what are we echoing? Oh, query. All right, we're gonna echo query and pipe it to tr and replace every one of the little, you know, blanky blank lines with a little plus sign. Take that, go in here, do the exact same thing, except for this time we need to do it a little, I don't know why I did that, we need to do this a little differently. Do the tilde to that, and of course to there. This is looking good. So here we go. Let's feel it out. All right, let's run it. Let's do Golang. Let's do slice. Sometimes I think I could be more than a script kitty. But we know that's not true. All right, let's do tmux new window, and let's pass in cheat sheet. Oh, yeah, Golang. Query. AOEU, baby. This is looking good. We got something amazing. You followed me in the middle of the best part? What? Thanks, UTFT. So let's hit that, man. Let's hit that tmux. Oh, man, tmux. Oh, wait. What happened? When the shell command completes, the window closes. Okay. All right. So let's kind of do two things at once here. First, I'm going to go like this. Tmux, new window, because I don't want to have to, you know, I don't want to put it on the outside. And let's put all of this in here, except for we need to add a little something special, okay? Let's also go like this. While, and then it's going to look like, still sleep one done. Oh, come on, please. I don't think I got it right. It did not. It didn't, you know, show the good stuff. Okay. I feel like I messed this up. I feel like I messed it up. First try. I knew I was going to get it. I knew I was the best. I knew it. All right. So let's redo our cheat sheet. Let's do Golang. Let's do slice. And now I am clearly the smartest man that has ever walked this earth. Let's do that again. Golang query slice. Oh, yeah. Is this what victory tastes like? Is this what it tastes like? Now, when I quit it, I need to go back, okay? I don't know about you, but I just broke out in sweat. All right, so now we need a little tmux shortcut for this to work out, okay? And so let's open up my tmux config. Let's go in here and let's go bind key dash ri. I don't need I, okay? I already know what I is, which I can't even remember what it is because it's useless, okay? And now we need right here, we need to run a new window, okay? No, wrong. Yep, there we go. Perfect, first try. And let's go like that, and let's run it under dot files, cheat sheet. Forgot that one. There we go. Let's take that. Let's do a little command, a little prefix R. Boom. If we refresh, let's go like this. Prefix I. Golang. Query. Slice. All right, let's try this out in Vim now. Little prefix I. There we go. Let's get Lua. Let's get slice. Let's take this here. Oh, this is looking really good. So let's do a little tmux walking around. Let's yank that. Let's exit. Oh, it took me back and paste. Ooh. Now this, my friends, is developer productivity. Let's just take one of those, paste it into here, go here, boom, everything is looking good, and we pretty much have it. For me, I just love these things, okay? These are one of my favorite type of little scripts to have, right? They're pretty small, pretty straightforward to understand, and just so much just happened right there, right? And it is so dang useful. It literally just works all the time. And the best part about this is that I can actually execute this outside of tmux. Hey, I brought you something, okay? What is this? What is that? What is this? Why is the box so big looking? Live on Twitch here shortly, I'll be unboxing this beautiful dactyl. Manuform. Oh, keycaps! And we're going to see how good I am on a little dactyl Manuform, okay? Just try it a little, you know, just try it out. Get a little polyamorous with this keyboard lifestyle, okay? You can't say that about keyboard lifestyle. All right, I'll be doing that soon on Twitch. Jump in the Discord if you want those noties or to talk to other degenerates, okay? We got a whole degen army slowly growing, slowly spreading filth throughout the universe. I hope you enjoyed what I just exposed to your brain. My name's the Primogen.